What do you mean the computer scanners worked this whole time? You mean it could have digitized every art piece I've made for the past 2 years and it could have been better than it turned out to- Wait, is this thing on? Are we going? Oh, okay, we're going. Hello, cartoon fanatics, and welcome to another Cartoon Corner covering My Little Pony. Sorry, you, how much of that did you hear? Did you hear all of it? Yeah. Okay then, I'm just gonna move on. Let's go ahead and dive into this week's horse episode. This week we're going back into the main six and dealing with a little bit of sibling rivalry between Twilight and her older brother, Shining Armor. We learn in the beginning that I guess they've had sort of this balanced out competition between the two, as siblings do, to see which one is better at certain things. And their parents came up with like this whole complex charting system of how to do it, which makes sense because we've learned in previous seasons that Twilight's mom is all about those charts. And now it is officially accumulated into adulthood for them, where the princesses are going to oversee their last competition, so to speak, to win this sibling crowned thing, sibling rivalry, best sibling ever crowned thing. Look, I'm an only child. I don't quite understand sibling rivalry, but I know many can relate to this, so it's not really my place to attempt to understand it. I'm just a casual observer who's very confused, but is just gonna nod her head and kind of go along with things. So it all comes down to breaking into the castle, as we've seen many times. Equestria, especially Canterlot, and the princesses are super easy to take over. And it looks like after all these takeovers, they finally decided to actually put in some reinforcements and guards and, I don't know, protect the place like they should have been doing for years. I don't know how they survived before Twilight and crew came along, honestly. But the contest is Shining Armor's put up all these defenses to try and get into the castle to keep, you know, bad guys out. And Twilight's goal is to try and get inside of the castle in kind of Mission Impossible style to attempt to get this crown of ultimate sibling winning stuff as well. And as you can imagine, Twilight, of course, enlists her friends because that's kind of her go-to plan. And Shining Armor expects that, so her friends go, well, let's do everything he doesn't expect. And they try doing that, and it fails miserably, but it does lead to some pretty hilarious moments. Also, in the midst of them trying to do the opposite of what they're normally doing, we see Princess Luna giving Zephyr Breeze one of the positions of the guard, which we know that Zephyr Breeze is not good at this kind of stuff. He's kind of a little bit all in his head, and the second I saw him, I thought, that doesn't make sense. If Shining Armor's goal is to keep Twilight in, then why would he put Zephyr Breeze on the... Oh, is Luna's plan. So I started thinking that Luna was helping out Twilight, because she and Celestia also have some inner sibling beef, and as we've seen in the past, their rivalry can go pretty intense. So now it's kind of going, oh, so it's going to work. Twilight's plan is going to work, because Luna's in on the inside helping Twilight out. So after being the not-themselves plan fails, they just go with Twilight's original plan, which is to emphasize all of her friends' strengths and do what they do best in order to get inside. And she gets so close, and of course Shining Armor's there. And yeah, of course it doesn't work. I mean, we kind of expected that. And I thought, okay, this is where Luna shows that she's helping out Twilight, right? Well, in a twist that I was too tired to see, or it was super surprising, Spike gets the crown of ultimate siblingry. Yeah, I never thought of Spike as one of their siblings. We see baby Spike in some of the flashbacks with Twilight and Shining Armor doing the competition. But I mean, I've always kind of seen Spike as, you know, Twilight's assistant or her pet. And I know that Spike kind of gets a bad rap because depending on who's writing for him, he can be written very, very badly. But in this episode, he takes the stance of, I've always seen myself as their little brother, and they never really include me in their competition. So now we've got a three-sibling rivalry thing going on, and At this point, my poor only child self has no idea what to make of any of this, but Luna was helping him the whole time. Spike and Luna were working together. And that was just kind of an oh moment. Like, boy, you all got earned, even Celestia. You see Luna sitting there like, yeah, take that, sister. I did this. Me. So, I guess I enjoyed this episode not so much for Twilight and Shining Armor and interactions and their interactions with Spike so much as I enjoyed sort of the inner Celestia Luna battle in the background, because they had some stuff riding on this too. So at the end of the day, is the castle officially certified? Probably not, but it's nice to see that they're making some kind of effort to protect it at this point. Will Spike ever be considered more than sort of a sidekick or assistant character? Probably not. I mean, they do try their best to try and move Spike out of this limelight, but at this point, there's just been too many times that his character has backtracked that I'm not sure if I can take him seriously. Although, I did appreciate his effort in this episode, and while the twist was kind of fun, all this sort of stance from him about wanting to be a sibling to Twilight and Shining Armor kind of felt like it came out of nowhere. At least to me it did. We had a little bit of a moment in the episode where he's talking to Fluttershy about his feelings about that, but that's like the only time I ever got the sense that he even felt this way throughout the show. So, once again, Spike's character is all over the place, and I have no clue what to make of it, although it did make this episode fun, if you don't think about all the other episodes and how this technically doesn't make sense, and it makes Spike's character even more confusing. But, you know, other than that, it was fun, it was cute, another fun slice of life, My Little Pony episode. I'm still waiting for the main plot to come back in. I know that in My Little Pony it doesn't tend to come in until the final episodes of the season, but one can hope. One can hope. Please. I never know what to say about these slice of life episodes. I need something more substantial to talk about. So if you like this, make sure to put a hose up and press that like button. Here's a question for the comments below, because I've started posing these things and I kind of like it. I like reading the comments at the moment. I'm sure if this got more views, I would change my mind about that. But what are your opinions on Spike? At the beginning, I thought he was kind of like a cute little side character, and as the seasons have gone on, I'm kind of fed up with him, so to speak. I mean, he's still okay, he still has his moments, but there's just so many times that they misuse his character, and that kind of drives me bonkers. But hey, let me know what you think about Spike and his character below. Just a little warning for next week. Next weekend, I'm going away on this snow electronics kind of retreat out in the wilderness, so there will not be a review on My Little Pony for that week. I'm supposed to be back, hopefully, at the end of that weekend so I can still make a Star Versus review, but I don't know at this point. I know for sure there's not going to be a My Little Pony one. So if you're really grasping at the bit watching these My Little Pony reviews, that now you know. And don't worry, Star Versus fans, I am determined to cover every single episode of the last season, because I know I haven't exactly done that in the past. I tried it with season 3 and I kind of fell through after the Alex Hirsch Blood Moon Kiss episode thing. But I'm going to make it happen, even with the No Electronics Retreat next weekend. I'm going to make it happen in some way. So, yeah, everyone have a good Easter. Or not, if you don't enjoy Easter. Just have a good weekend in general.